Now, as you may know, I've been campaigning on a platform of prosperity through peace. But after much thought, I have decided to end my campaign for the president today. Thank you. But I would like to take this opportunity one last time to advocate for a chance be given to peace. Since today is all about women's leadership, it reminds me of one of my favorite Greek plays, Lysistrata, a comedy from 400 BC by Aristophanes. Now, in that play, a group of women, fed up with the warmongering of their husbands, agree to, and how do I say this appropriately, withhold their favors until peace returns. And it worked. They ended the Peloponnesian Wars. Well, anyway, let's talk about the present. Studies show that women tend to lead differently than men, and that women are more likely to be collaborative and team-oriented. It is undeniable the benefits women provide to the pursuit of peace. Now, when I was a senator, a general from the Pentagon testified before the Foreign Relations Committee on global military powers. And I asked him, who was second to the United States in military might? And he thought for a bit, and then he said, probably the UK. Now, yes, that was a few years ago, but the point remains true. No real rival to the United States exists when it comes to total weaponry. Now, we make Virginia-class submarines in Rhode Island, and I've been on an overnight patrol. What a phenomenal piece of technology and craftsmanship, a machine bristling with the most advanced power imaginable. And submarines are just one instrument in our staggeringly efficient arsenal of war. And yet, we are sinking ever deeper and deeper into an endless morass in the Middle East and North Africa. People keep dying and peace seems further and further away. It's evident that all this military power isn't working for us right now.